If the cathedral is the religious center of Florence, then this building is the political center. It's known to the world as the Palazzo Vecchio. Now let's work on your Italian language skills a bit as well. Palazzo is the Italian word for palace, and Vecchio means old. Of course, it doesn't make sense to build something and to call it old immediately. That is not the original name. The original name of the building was the Palazzo della Signoria. And I'm standing here in the Piazza della Signoria. The Signoria was the name that Florence gave to its executive city council. 9 men who were elected into office. In fact, probably the most important thing I can tell you about Florence historically is that during its heyday, it was one of the few republics in Europe. Most of Europe was monarchy of one form or another at this time. And this building has served as the seat of that democracy here in Florence for the last 700 years. Now, I think most of us would be hard pressed to describe that building as looking like what we think a town hall should look like. In fact, it looks much more like a castle or a prison or a fortress. And the reason is because when it came time to build the town hall, they had no idea what a town hall should look like. And the reason is because there weren't any at this time. So they borrowed that style of a fortified structure to give the message of power and authority. But at the same time, it's a style of architecture that protected the lives of the men who worked inside the building. Now consider that democracy is a very fragile thing. And on paper, the Florentines were happy that they were controlling themselves. But every time that council made an unpopular decision, those very people who elected them would form into what we call a lynch mob. And they would storm that building and they would try to string these guys up. So what do the men inside the building do? Well, they protect themselves. In fact, if you look up at that row of arches, the overhang there on the palazzo, each arch, which aligns with a window or a door on the ground level, has a rectangular opening or hole inside facing straight down to that window or door. And those holes are called drop holes. And they were used to discourage people from attacking the building. They would drop pretty much anything your imagination can dream up. Boiling oil, boiling tar, rocks, arrows, you name it. And so the moral is the building just didn't look like a castle or a fortress. It functioned as one as well. And the style of that building is a direct reflection of the political climate in Florence when it was built around the year 1300. And we know things calm down when they start putting statues in front of City Hall. And the most famous of those statues is Michelangelo's David. The sculpture that you see behind me is a copy, but the original statue of David stood in this exact spot for 369 years until it was moved into the Academia Gallery in 1873.